Welcome back for the scripting tutorial. This is exercise 3. We are almost right where we left off. I've made some slight changes and I will show them to you now. First, I added these parameters in the user CFG file. The first one suppresses the error message we are getting at the editor startup. This one breaks the tree execution whenever it runs into an error. The third one forces nodes into dynamically adjusting their size to fit their content. Like this. This helps us to see all the parameters in the nodes at first glance. This parameter defines when the nodes change their visual style from normal to the LOD style as you are zooming. And the rest of the parameters simply change the visual style of the link debug draw to make it more visually pleasing. The other thing I did was that I added a new XML file into user editor, sandbox, xgen npc editor folder, this file. This file customizes the node toolbar here. It changes the size of the icons so they take up less screen space. And more crucially, it defines custom shortcuts for some of the most frequently used nodes. This helps me to speed up the process of adding new nodes. I can still add the sequence node, for example, in this old clumsy way, or instead, I can simply hold down the left mouse button, and as you can see here, all these shortcuts appear. The sequence is under S, so while holding down the left mouse button, I simply press S, and the sequence node is inserted. And that is much faster. So let's start the actual exercise. The goal of this exercise is to make the NPC follow the player indefinitely. Additionally, the NPC should dynamically change the speed of its movement based on the distance from player. And when the NPC gets close enough, it should again play the hand wave animation. Let's do this whole problem step by step. The first thing we're gonna need is to create a new behavior on the smart area. It will be called moveToPlayer and it will be stored in the same XML file. Let's define the behavior. We want the NPC to move indefinitely, so we need a loop and move. The destination of the move will be the player, who is stored in the global variable double_player. That's it for now, so let's save the behavior and let's make the NPC call this new behavior. Now, when I jump in, we will experience some problems. The first thing is that the NPC's brain is failing. This error window appears thanks to the second parameter I added to the user CFG file. When you press the pause button, the XGen editor will zoom in on the cause of the problem. The red color signalizes that the move node has failed. And the cause of this problem is very simple. I just jumped into the level from too high up and the NPC is trying to get to me while I'm not anywhere near the nav mesh. There's a very easy fix for that. Let's just add a delay that will give the player enough time to drop to the ground. Let's save the behavior and jump into the game mode again. And this is the second problem. It's the player's brain failing. The player's entity has the brain player, which expects the level to be fully realized, which this flat plane isn't. We have to change the player's brain. For this, we have to go to the NPC editor, click Edit, Edit Player, and change the brain to default. The default brain does nothing, so there is nothing that could fail. You have to save the level and reload the AI script for it to take effect. Let's finally see what this NPC does. Notice that the NPC indeed does go to me, but when I move someplace else, he first reaches my old position and only then he starts moving to my new position. That approximation is not good enough. We want him to dynamically update the destination as we are moving. We have to use the additional parameters property of the move node. We have to create and set a new variable of this type, which is unique to the move node. The type is called additional move params. And we have to set it to value test changed threshold with time in parentheses. We'll use 200 milliseconds. This setup will force the move node to reevaluate every property value and to recalculate the path 5 times a second. Save the behavior and jump in the game. As you can see, the NPC is following me very closely and is reacting quickly to any change in my position. Now let's continue with some changes. We want the NPC to not bump into us. We actually want him to stop within some distance, let's say 1 meter. So the NPC will move within 1 meter's distance. And then we want him to play the animation. Let's just copy it from the other behavior. And as the next step, we should control when and how he should again start reacting to our movement. We don't want him to move when we keep staying close. He should only resume moving towards us when we get too far. For that, we should use a node called distance gate that will help us to pause the whole loop. Gate type nodes work this way. They are waiting until a specified condition is met, and then they, air quotes, open and start executing their subtree. By default, distance gate waits until the distance between two points or entities is lower than the low value. The difference between the high and low values serves as a sort of hysteresis. So after getting close, the condition would then stop being true only when we get farther than the high value. We don't want the gate open when being close, but rather when getting far, so we have to negate the condition. This now means we only care about the high value. Let's set it to 4 meters. When we get that far from the NPC, we simply let this part succeed. And then this whole loop can finally repeat. The only thing our distance gate is missing are the two entities whose distance the gate will keep measuring. So we need this ID for the NPC and player for player. Save the behavior and let's test it. Good, the NPC stopped not too close and he waved. Let's walk around him and now let's try to get far. Perfect, but it's not everything we want from this exercise. We also want the NPC to dynamically change his speed. When he's too far, he should run, and when he's close, he should walk. The additional params variable in the move node already ensures that any change will be reflected in no later than 200 milliseconds. This means that the only thing we have to do is to feed the move node the correct speed data, and the node will almost immediately react to any change. For the speed data, we will need a new variable. It will be of the type string, and we will set the initial value to run. Now, any node field with predefined values can be changed into reading the value from a variable. You do that by right-clicking the field and selecting the option Switch to Variable Name. Now we can enter our new variable called speed. We will control the speed in a tree executed in parallel. So we'll use a node called parallel, which keeps executing its children all the time. Again, we want this secondary tree to be looped. And we also want to use another distance gate, but we'll use it in a different way. Of course, we will be measuring the distance between this ID and player. And this time, we do not want to negate the condition. We also want to use advantage of the hysteresis. Let's set the low value to 6 and the high value to 10. So when the NPC is closer than 6 meters, we want to set its speed to walk. We will use the node called expression. Expressions are used for all basic variable operations, like setting values, copying values, some math, and so on. One thing I have to finally address here is the dollar sign. You might have noticed that it keeps appearing and disappearing in some nodes. A dollar sign simply tells the parser to treat the following word as a variable and not as an operator or a literal. Many fields in the nodes are preset to only accepting variables, so they automatically delete this dollar sign and pretend it to be there implicitly. However, you have to follow the dollar sign syntax strictly in expression. And then we will do a trick with this endless wait. One more thing I have to explain about distance gate is the onEvent termination property. When set to default value, keep running, the gate keeps being open even when the condition ceases to be true. So we want to set it to halt. And this is why we have the endless wait there. When we get too far, which is now set to 10 meters, the gate will close or halt, and this will kill the waiting. Of course, this means that the distance gate will end and the preceding sequence will try to execute another child. So the next step is simply to reset the speed back to run. We could of course use another expression, or we can use a different handy tool called var operation with operation set to reinit. And we will simply reinitialize the speed back to run, which is its default value as specified here. Now that should be all. Save the behavior and let's test it. So far, everything seems fine. Now I will just press F9 to pause the execution. And I will also adjust the view at the tree so we can see it in live debug. Click back into the viewport and press F9 again to unpause. Let's now concentrate on me getting far. The gate is clearly open and the wait is waiting. And now he's running, let's pause. You might have noticed that the subtree of the distance gate was blue and green. But then this whole part was killed as the distance gate halted, and then the speed was set back to run. This is the end of exercise 3. Congratulations for finishing it. See you next time.